square feet. So a parking reduction of some sort would obviously be needed for this site. Excuse me. As I stated before, the operational characteristics of the business were compelling for the approval of the parking reduction. Additionally, the conditions of approval in the CUP address those concerns relative to the use of the site with the vehicle repair. No servicing of vehicles outdoors, no vehicle sales use is allowed, no vehicle-related retail sales, no vehicle washing, no vehicle storage, no towing services. To conclude, it's categorically exempt from CEQA. It's consistent with the zoning code and general plan. The CUP that Planning Commission approved allows the major vehicle repair use with conditions, and the 67% parking reduction allows reuse of this existing building. And the parking reduction is necessary to allow a reasonable range of uses similar to other properties in that district. And our recommendation is that City Council affirm the findings, which are the same ones that the Planning Commission established and adopted, and adopt the City Council resolution finding the proposed use and the parking reduction exempt from CEQA, and uphold the Planning Commission's approval of the conditional use permit, subject to those same conditions approval.
Okay, thank you. Before we hear from anyone, we'll go ahead and take council questions, and then if Gloria or the owner of the building wants to speak during public comment, we'll give them an opportunity to do that. So any council questions? Councilmember Lutz.
I have a question, and Abigail, I don't know if this is for you really or for our attorney, and I asked her this yesterday, and I still want to get something clear in my mind. If you reduce, if we hold the applicant to the number of spaces according to the general plan, and I think one of your slides said there'd only be, they'd only be able to have what, a funeral home, a tiny restaurant, or an artist studio. That seems to me that's pretty much reducing the owner's ability to run a business, and therefore wouldn't that be really considered a taking in fact or de facto? Wouldn't that be a taking, and we would have to end up buying the property?
That sounds like a question for the attorney, maybe?
My response yesterday to Councilmember Lutz's question, I think that is the dilemma that we have, and that is why the code, which gives you some discretion to grant some flexibility in connection with the parking conditions on the property, is, you know, does exist. It's if you can make some of the findings which staff and the Planning Commission to date have made, you can be a little bit more flexible, and so that it's not just limited to a funeral home and the other few items. The rules about takings are quite complicated, and I to be honest with you, I haven't completely researched them at this moment, but I would say generally if you do allow some use of the property, it's not a taking. There's further refinements on that if something can be considered a regulatory taking, but I don't believe we're triggering that at this point, particularly not if the Planning Commission decision is affirmed.
And I appreciate that answer. I think that was really my concern, and I really appreciate our general plan and the flexibility that's built in to the general plan that we can have this, because otherwise I think the owner is going to be stuck with these kind of alternatives, and none of them would work in that location. So thank you for that.
Okay. Sergio?
On the restrictions, no storage, does that include overnight storage of a vehicle that's been repaired? Or are you meaning no permanent storage of vehicles? Which It's not clear which one is it.
Okay, for the vehicle storage, there is a definition in the zoning code specifically of vehicle storage, which we have a code here. I could look it up.
Just want to make sure we're not restricting.
I think it means more than, right. I think the definition, Courtney will correct me if I'm wrong. I think vehicle storage in the definition is if it's like more than 24 hours.
Okay.
I vaguely remember there's some specific time in there.
So is that pretty?
We can look it up right now.
Okay. Is that pretty typical for a major repair shop? Because I had my car fixed and it was there for 7 days because it was fixing transmission and engine. So that's major repair. And it was there stored there for 7 days. I just want to make sure we're not restricting them to having a vehicle that's got ongoing repairs and for some reason, parts or whatever, that we're not restricting and say, now you're going to get a ticket because you're holding a car more than that. To the extent that our court enforcement folks are good, they might find this in a way, you know, or the competitor, because I think there's some friction there about competition and all that, and I just don't want to see them getting a ticket later on because they have a car that's ongoing, that's got ongoing repairs, versus them parking an antique car there permanently. So I think that just want to see if the definition is more clear.
Apparently in the definition there isn't a time. Maybe that was from the previous code. But anyways, vehicle storage, lots for the storage and parking of tow away and towed vehicles. Impound yards and storage lots for vehicles, trucks, buses, and recreational vehicles. Excludes salvage and wrecking operations. So this lot with this CUP is not approved for vehicle, you know, storage.
Right.
So the parking spaces that are there, any cars could be, you know, parked there.
Sure.
And then, of course, the parking inside the building, you know, having the cars inside, that's fine. That's part of the operational.
Right.
How they operate.
Right.
So we didn't get into that level of saying whether they could have that they can't have some car there for
right
7 days
and,
or.
And the reason I raised the issue is because there was concern from neighboring businesses, and I can just see somebody complaining, you have a car there for more than 24 hours, therefore I'm calling court enforcement, and court enforcement shows up and says it's not clear enough, so I'm going to give you a citation. So I mean, I can understand parking an RV, parking a boat, parking a vehicle that's it needs permanent what do you call that, when you're fixing an old car and just takes years to fix it, a project, I can see that being different as being storage. But having a vehicle that needs ongoing repairs or parts are late or whatever, I give you my example, 7 days in Commission Street, actually, they were fixing the transmission, and that took 7 days. So, I mean, are they going to be in that kind of situation?
Council member, I think the intent of the conditional use permit and the conditions there are primarily directed towards outdoor storage, and outdoor storage is specifically prohibited. There isn't a storage yard on site, obviously, so any storage of vehicle that's being worked on obviously would take place inside the building, and that's a building owner's decision, or the business owner's decision to conduct all those activities inside the building. So
they couldn't at the end of the day push the car out that still needs repair and park it in their parking lot? Would they be in violation?
Store it overnight? No, they couldn't.
Okay. Is that pretty typical and customary with other repair shops?
Again, they don't have an outdoor storage yard. So
they do have a parking.
They do have a parking lot, but keep in mind that any vehicle that they're working on, they're liable for.
I understand that.
For that building. So, yeah, but to answer your question directly, no, they would not be permitted to park
a car outside
overnight outdoors.
Okay. because that's kind of a practice out there. You know this. And I just don't want to see them being targeted for something that everybody else is kind of doing, because I think they're going to be under everybody's microscope. And so what I would like to see is, you know, and I guess we get to the comments, but I would like to see us define a little bit more so he's kind of clear what that means, no storage, and for others, and especially when we're going to try to go enforce parking or storage outside.
And we've had fairly extensive conversations with Councilmember De La Rosa and the applicants, and certainly they can explain that a little bit more, their understanding as well. I think we're all in agreement that there would be no outdoor work on the vehicles or outdoor storage.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. We'll go ahead and would the applicant like to speak, and I'll give you up to 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mayor. My name is Christine Kemp, and I'm actually here representing the property owner, Mr. and Mrs. Vitalgio. The applicant is also the tenant who wants to come in, and they actually have their name on the permit, and I know that Mrs. Arias wants to speak as well. We very much want you to uphold the Planning Commission's decision. I'm a little concerned about the framing of the question, whether it's a denial of the appeal or if it's like a de novo hearing and you actually have to approve the use permit, because that may make a difference on how a split vote on a denial would deny the appeal and uphold the Planning Commission's recommendation, which I think is what I thought was going to be happening today. You have a Planning Commission recommendation for approval of this project, and then it was appealed. If the appeal's denied, the Planning Commission recommendation stays. It was unanimously approved by the Planning Commission. It was also approved by the RDA, the Redevelopment Agency. So you have the two advisory committees have approved that. It is a 1978 building. It's been in use for 32 years. It's been in use as some form of auto shop. Abby indicated, there are several conditions on the use permit. It limits the types of uses, and as Mr. Councilman Sanchez said, all activities are to be inside. The parking is just for customers who are coming. It is an inside activity. It's not outside. The planning manager can review if there's a problem with the operation. That's another condition of approval, condition number 6, that the planning manager can review if there's a problem. And there's the standard condition number 34 about no nuisance to the neighborhood. So I think it's well protected. Mrs. Arias can describe more about their business, but this is a good tenant. They've had an auto repair business before. It is a mom and pop business. They don't have employees. The two of them do that. They work really at one car at a time. So if they're able to get 4 cars inside that facility, they really are well equipped. They're not going to be creating a spilling out onto the street and creating a nuisance in that neighborhood. There were 30 letters or signatures in support that were in your staff report, so it's not just that there isn't support in the neighborhood for this. There is support in the neighborhood, and we want you to keep that in mind. They also do have backup parking, backup parking available if that ever were to be the case. There were 2 letters, I think they were in your staff report, and if you don't have them, I can turn them in, but they have acquaintances who have auto sales and storage facilities that if they needed to store vehicles, they can store them off-site. It's because they understand that it is a limited parking area. I drove by the site. It's lots of types of those auto repair types of businesses there, so it seems like an appropriate use, and I would think that it would be somewhat discriminatory against these folks to say they can't have an auto repair business when that whole block is kind of dotted with that type of business. So we would encourage you to uphold what the Planning Commission did. I have some photographs of the area. I don't know if your overhead shows, but I can turn those into the city for your review. I think that the charge against this is primarily by a competitor who perhaps is uncomfortable with the same type of business moving into the neighborhood. And I understand everybody, you know, is looking out for their own businesses, but we really think this is a benefit to the neighborhood. They've been good tenants out where they've been. They're looking for even a better site where they can operate their business. So we would encourage you to uphold what the Planning Commission did. it, and this is these people's livelihood. It's their business. We have an owner who wants to have a tenant, not have a vacant building. The tenants are kind of under a time constraint. They're actually paying double rent right now because they assumed they would be able to move into this place. And so we would encourage